I'm going to create a simple database in Microsoft Access 2007. Access differs from other Microsoft Office applications because it does not open up to a blank document. Instead, we first need to specify where we wish to save our document before we create it. I'm going to begin by clicking on the blank database icon. And then I select where I want to save my database by clicking on the open folder icon, which indicates that I'm browsing for a location. I'm going to create this database on my desktop. And I'm going to give it the file name, Books. Now that I've specified a location and file name, I can click on the Create button. Access opens to an empty table in Datasheet view. The first thing I want to do is view this table in Design view. I'm going to right-click on my table and select Design view. It asks me for a name for the table. I'm going to type Books. Now in Design view, it shows me a field that has already been set up in my table called ID. Notice to the left of the ID field is a key indicator. This means that this field is the table's primary key. A primary key is a unique piece of information that identifies a row in a table. Notice the data type for this field is auto number. This means that each new record in this table will have a unique number generated from a sequence. I'm going to add a field name for my table, and I'm going to call this field title, and I'm going to select the text data type. I'm going to select another field and call this field published, and I will select the number data type. The number data type means that only a number can be stored in this field. I cannot store a text value in this field. I'm going to right-click on my table name and open the table back in Datasheet view. Before I can open the table, it asks me if I first want to save my changes to the table, and I will click on Yes. I will now begin entering information into my table. Like Microsoft Excel, I could expand my column widths. This does not change the data, but it makes it easier to enter data. Now that I have entered data into my books table, I'm going to create a new table called Authors. I click on the Create ribbon, click on Table, and it creates a new table in Datasheet view. I want to add fields using Design view, so I'm going to right-click on my table name. I can right-click on my table name in the navigation pane, or I can right-click on my table name in the tab above the table. And then I go into Design view. First, I need to name my table, and I'm going to name my table Authors. Again, it's created a default ID field with the data type of auto number. And again, this field is the primary key for this table. The ID field in the Authors table will uniquely identify each record, each row in the Authors table. I'm using the tab key to quickly move between fields to assist in data entry. Now that I've created my fields, I will enter the table in Datasheet view, and again saving my table. I will now add the authors to my database. Now that I've added the authors to my database, I want to create a relationship between my books and authors table. In order to create this relationship, I will need to add a field in my books table that will indicate the author that wrote the book. I'm going to go back to my books table and I'm going to enter Design view. I'm going to add a new field and call it Author ID. Because the ID field in the authors table is an auto number data type, I'm going to make sure I'm using a number data type so I can enter the numbers and create the relationship. If I used a different data type, then I would not be able to create the relationship because the data types would not match. I'm now going to close and save both of my tables, and I'm going to click on the Database Tools ribbon, and then click on Relationships. The Show Table dialog box appears, and I'm going to use the Control button to select my second table, and then I will click on the Add button to add both of the tables. When I see that both of the tables are in my Relationships screen, I'm going to click on Close for the Show Table dialog box. In order to create the relationship, I select the field that I want to relate and drag that field onto the field in the other table that I want to relate to, and then let go, dragging the author ID field in the books table to the ID field in the authors table. When I let go, the Edit Relationship box appears, showing me that I am relating the ID field in the authors table to the author ID in the books table. I'm going to check the box Enforce Referential Integrity, and notice that my relationship type is one to many. When I click on Create, I can see that I have a one-to-many relationship. This means that one author can write many books. I'm going to close out of my relationship window, saving my changes. And I'm going to go to the books table and begin entering author IDs to relate authors to their books. Looking at the authors table, I can see the name of the author I'm relating, and as I add the authors, I can see the effect of the relationship. Notice that the highest ID that I have in my authors table is 4. If I try to add an author ID to the books table that doesn't exist in the authors table, I will get an error. You cannot add or change a record because a related record is required in tables. This is called referential integrity, and it's one of the many features of a relational database that intends to keep the data valid. I can only add authors to books that actually exist in the authors table, so I do not get invalid data. Before I can see my changes in the authors table, I'll need to close out of the authors table and reopen that as well. I can now see that each author is related to the books that they have written.